whether you kind of hurt something at some point and learn to walk like that to minimise pain from it.
Yeah, so
and whether, you know, whether that's kind of been pain avoidance thing that's developed into a habit. So yeah, so I thought, okay, well, there's no real point in pushing him into canter when he's not strong enough to hold it.
Yeah.
Without the girth done up, then absolutely I have no problem whatsoever with you getting on from the ground. If you can't, then please use the down. Pushing the head up.
Yeah.
You see lots and lots and lots of people that go up this way with the bridle.
Oh God, no.
And it's like,
I can't even do that.
Why are you pushing the horse's head up?
Yeah.
To put the bridle on? Or to put the halter on?
With the stride that he has and the way he moves and walk and the way he moves and trot, there's not too much wrong there. It's just so right, isn't it?
He is stunning. Thank you.
lot of trouble. I had a shit of an instructor who, I started with an instructor that put me on to this guy. They were sort of friends and she moved.
Yep.
But they both rode off the spur. So I learned very well to ride off the spur and had a tense horse that I couldn't catch when I wanted to ride it. And then I met Linda and then my horse started to like me.
Yeah.
It was really sad when I realised.
Yeah.
Mate, I've got to stop ogling him.
Alright, so what I've taught him for getting on is...
Thank you.
circle first. So that we've got a little bit of a bend. Thank you.